just one octave up, or some whistle. What's up, guys? So today I'm following up from the last few videos where we look at old songs, and today I thought I'd give feedback to actually recently released recordings. I'll be going through what I think is good, what I think is bad, why I think so, and just in general my mistakes that I think I've done over the last few years. Hopefully that can be fun and valuable for you guys to watch. Follow me on Instagram for more stuff like this and good karma, and as always, one of the first 500 commenters will win a free mastering done by me. I haven't slept in almost 2 days, but I'll shut up now and let's dive into it with the first single that I ever released in 2015. It's supposed to be a club song, and then it can't go down into this like super emotional part with no energy, no rhythm elements and anything. And it's way too long as well. It's pretty to listen to, but it was supposed to be, I tried to make a club track. The vocal is okay, I don't like it anymore, but at the time I felt like it fit. I think this is the interesting part. Yeah. That's so bad. It sounds like a bad like DJ mix. It doesn't fit at all. Having go before the drop, I don't think that's ever a good idea, to be honest. Yeah, it just doesn't match the break whatsoever. So this is one of my earliest tracks, so there's a lot to say about this, but primarily it's like, try to keep the record in one idea. This was just two completely separate ideas, and one was like almost a film cinematic track. Let's go to the next one though, because this is my song with Robbie East on Hell Deep Records. It's a way stronger start already, because you have very like recognizable chords and sounds from the get-go. I think should have brought in some snap or something there already, because it's supposed to be a club track as well. Now there's been 15 seconds with pretty much nothing going on to keep the rhythm going. Really good with the drums. It's little stuff like that really improves the flow of the track, I think. The vocal fits really well as well. I like that. Okay, so that's really smart. I think Robbie came up with that, adding like beginning to chop up the vocal instead of having it repeat again, and also adding a new melody on top of that. That really helped move the record forward and to keep it fresh. I should have done like a cutoff filter on the chords, because there was a bit too much going on there, I think. But other than that, it's fine. That's really interesting that the melody continues into the build. I've never thought of that, because it's not the drop melody. Now there's a different melody. But it still fits, I think. It still fits, which is cool. I think Robbie did that. I was not good enough at that time to do that. That was a really good trick. I should do that more often. I think Calvin Harris does it in his track Summer. And when I think of it, he has his ARP going in the build, which is really cool. The drop is fine. I like that it's pretty unique at the time, at least. But there's just way too much going on with like percussions and... with like the double claps, it's just way too much going on. I would have kept it way cleaner, but it's a pretty good track. I like it. I think there's something here as well to be noted. That there's like an ARP coming in towards the end of the drop. Which then glues into the next part and makes it way more of a, like a journey to listen to. It sounded wavy. Let's head over to 2016. This is Temple. instantly like a vibe. It's not, again, I was terrible at making club songs because this is really hard for a DJ to play. It just kills the mood instantly when it's like 30 seconds of just Chinese ambient sounds, you know? But it sets the mood, and what I think is really strong about this record is that it has a theme. I think that's one of the most important things nowadays. There are so many tracks being released every day, and they're so good, all of them. So to stand out, you really need to have like a concept, which is something I really try to do with my records nowadays. We like I Don't Speak French, I Dippy Dip, they're really specific records to make them help stand out in the crowd. And this is one of the first ones where I felt like, or I didn't even know it at the time, but looking back at it now, it really, really works. The title is Temple and the melody in the drop. Like everything is Asian inspired. You have these vocal chops that sound Asian, the Chinese flavor all over. It's really, really specific, which I think is a big takeaway to take home, if that makes sense. Let's continue on with my first release on Spinin' in 2016. It also has this epic break, but not too danceable still. It's more of like a listening track, but I was still trying to make these clubby drops. But it ended up being more of a listening record. It didn't get a lot of DJ support, I think. I know Avicii played it a lot, which was crazy, but other than that, it didn't really get any DJ support, probably because of the arrangement. But I really like the vocoder thing. It's pretty cool. It's got a unique flavor, which is good. The claps, they feel a bit too sloppy and wet. I would maybe go for just check in my sample packs here. It may be something like the claps from Meet You. You can download all these for free, by the way, on my website. I also think the main lead could be a bit stronger. It's a bit thin. Yeah, definitely could add like some super sauce just to bring it forward a bit. The white noise is also a bit too wavy. I think you could be more harsh with the white noise there. But yeah, it's a pretty good track. Okay, so this is my last release before I disappeared for a little while. I was trying to go for really minimalistic style. It's a bit boring. I think I could do more automations with the bass synth. It's just a bit boring, but I like the arrangement. It's pretty efficient. I think the biggest mistake here was twofold. I think one thing that I learned in the I Dip You Dip record, which I'll talk about later, is that the sub needs to have one more layer, because right now it's only like the sub layer, like rolls off at like 200 hertz and you just miss that 500 hertz to 1000 hertz bass that would really help make it more powerful. And also, I was trying to go for like minimalism, but my production just wasn't good enough at the time. So the main lead could use more automation and things to just make it more interesting, I think. I like the snare claps, but I think they could be tighter as well. So primarily it's just I really should have one more layer of a bass that would fill out. And also some more white noise. Yeah, there's almost no white noise here. I think I could use some more reverb on the lead as well. It's a bit too dry, I think. Speaking of reverb, I actually found another version that I did, but it ended up being way too much reverb. But this is how that sounded. So that was the other way around. It was a bit too overkill. Okay, so Blackbird with ELS. Already there, it's just too boring of a start, I think. We made this back in 2017 almost, I think. Shout out to ELS, he's amazing, by the way. It was really good to work on this record with him. In 2017, it was more acceptable. I feel in recent years, it's just been the attention span of the listener has just gone down drastically. So you need to get attention so quick, and this just doesn't work, I think. This part is cool, but it's still like, it doesn't like really shout at you, if that makes sense. It doesn't pop. Honestly, the track could actually start just right here. That's something interesting right away. I like this, but it's... just overall, I think there is too much going on. So it sort of ends up being this little mush. I think we should maybe have specified it a bit and have like one bass layer and one vocal. Just try and clean it up a bit. But I like the melody and the vocal thing. It's cool. And the clap could just be a bit tighter, but other than that, I like it actually. Let's head over to IDP Dip, which was released just 7 months ago, I think, which was my comeback track. So this is gonna be interesting if I see something or hear something I don't like here. It catches attention immediately. That's very good. I like that. Fun fact about this song, I was actually unsure about ever releasing it because I thought it was too weird with this drop. I was very unsure actually, but I sent it to Brooks for feedback and he loved it, played it, and then Don Diablo heard it and signed it. So I was like, okay, people like it, which is really, really cool because I thought it was way too weird. But the melody is good. Oh. I remember I couldn't get that bass right, the sound of it. I really like the melody, adds nicely to it, but the sound just never sat with me, I think. Has a bit too much attack. The sound is a bit too wet, I think, as well. I think it should be a bit drier, tighter. Takes up a bit too much space as well. The build could be a bit stronger as well, I think. I really like this drop, actually. It's unique, it's catchy, or catchy. It's very, has a nice groove. I like this a lot. The only thing I can't stand is the snare clap. It feels, it's too big for some... I don't know if you guys feel the same way, but I think it should be a bit more techie. Like that clap. I think a lot more DJs would be able to play it if it had that sort of clap and a bit like tighter kick, maybe that kick. Because right now it's this kick. And I think that kick would have punched a bit through harder. It's good to have this switch up, it really helps the track move along. So that second part really helped, but this is for DJs like to transition into, but I think it still could be a bit more, have some more movement to it. Maybe like a synth that go bum 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 bum, just that would help a lot, just pitching up. So let's head over to Strangers Do, which is probably the record I'm most proud of. By the way, you can check out the making of this record, IDP Dip, Blackbird, and I Don't Speak French, and all of those on my channel. I'll put one of them up here on some card or something. But Strangers Do is, I think that's probably the one track where I feel like I've put the most I've learned into one song at one time, if that makes sense. So it starts off with the vocals saying Strangers Do, which is instantly recognizable, with the chords, the guitar chords that I'm playing. And also the main melody is introduced ASAP, which is me going, which is also really funny. I hope I don't ruin the song now that you know that, but so it's playing all those tricks and it brings in a rhythm element pretty quickly. It could have come a bit earlier, I think, though. I really like the vocal, she's singing amazingly. The lyrics in the verse is good, but I think the lyrics in the chorus here. When I wrote them, I hadn't written songs for too long, so I was still learning, and I think they're a bit too... they don't flow as nice as I would like to, and they're a bit too wavy, maybe, the lyrics. But they definitely work. It's just a small thing that I noticed right now. And something that I've noticed when I play it out live is that the build is a bit too weak. Or the drop is just too heavy for the build, really. And one thing I also noticed is here, when the drop repeats itself the second time, that the lead should change. I think I should have put an octave above, like just one octave up, or some whistle. Some whistle would really fit well, I think. It's staying a bit too much of the same, I think, throughout the drop. I feel like that's it for this record, but I also want to say that good trick to try and make the melody not like start on the one, because here the melody sort of starts before, so you have. Which was a bit of a creative twist that you can try yourself. It's fun to try and challenge yourself to do melodies another way, and sometimes good stuff can come. Okay, let's head over to the 365 remix that I did just a couple of months ago. Which you can also check out the making of somewhere. I think I'm actually gonna do a separate video on how to remix a song, if you guys would be interested in that, because I have a remix coming very soon and I can do it with that, because here I have a lot of things to talk about, and also in the one that I'm doing, because I'm changing the chords, which helped a lot in this remix, and I want to go more in depth with that. So let me know if you want to see that. But what I think I learned mostly here was I made this when I was at the Musical Freedom Writing Camp in the Netherlands, and Toby Green, a really good friend of mine, he taught me a lot about kicks and claps, because usually my kicks and would sound like this and this, and that would sound really alike. The kick here sounds like that. It sounds completely different, and it just changed my world, because I'd always thought you had to have this specific sound, because I wanted that Don Diablo kick sound. Didn't sound as good as all, at all, but that was, and I just stick with it because I didn't really learn how to use other kicks. But he opened my world and showed me a lot about kicks, which was just super valuable. So shout out to Toby, one of the best producers out there. And he also, the claps was also a lot tighter, which I've showed. That I would never have thought of using something as simple. I think it's an 808 clap. Which is, it's so, when it's so simple and small, it just has a lot of energy. I don't know how to explain it. It sounds more tech housey, which is really cool as well. Give it up. Cooler, more modern groove. So I feel like when he showed me that, my sound evolved into a more mature sound, if that makes sense. Because I feel like a lot of my stuff was sounding a bit too immature, if that makes sense. Let's head over to I Don't Speak French, which is my second to last single.
I came Paris, I wanted to see Eiffel Tower.
I'm sorry if I'm talking too much, but I'm just excited, and it's a lot of fun. So I tried to do like the minimalism thing again with David and Goliath. But here I feel like my production has gotten a bit better, so I was able to do it more efficiently.
I wanted to see, but all I kept hearing was Parlez-vous French, adieu.
I feel like I was better at manipulating the sounds that I had so that it didn't end up sounding boring.
French,
there is a lot going on, but it's still controlled versus Fall Under Skies, which is just random perks all over. Now I have, for instance, this. That perk is pretty much the only perk, but it's like so strong and so loud, and it's just, it's all very balanced in comparison to what I've done 5 years ago or even 10. It's a lot going on, but it's still very minimal. Guys, I think that's pretty much it for that one. You can also check out the making of and let me know what you guys think. I'm really curious what you think of these records, and just, I would love to hear some feedback, because I always want to get better, obviously. This is my last single with Mesto. We premiered it at Slam. You can check out my whole set here somewhere. And it was so much fun making this with him. I love Mesto. You have a rhythm element going in ASAP. Super short first break, which is something that I really like doing nowadays. The best part about this, to me, is that I feel like I've learned how to make a DJ record, if that makes sense. This is way more playable than my previous tracks. I think also it's has that more of a mature mix sound with the kicks and claps, and just also being able to work with Mesto was amazing. I love that dude. And yeah, I think the second break is very interesting as well. So here we tried to get in more character into the song and have it more of a theme. So this is like cowboy, western type of guitar playing. And these chords are moving. So this break is way longer, which is something that is really cool because you get that very efficient first break and this, which brings it back into that DJ friendly area. It's a cool thing to do, I think. I like it a lot. So I think the main key takeaways that I've learned over the past few years that I hope is valuable to you as well is number one, catching the attention ASAP. Number two, having a really clear theme for the record to make it stand out. Three, using less sounds, but using them better. Changing chords in the song is really important to make it help it move forward, and just having more of an efficient arrangement is probably the sixth thing, I don't know. And using rhythm elements nicely to keep up the groove. Let me know what you think is the main takeaway and what you learned, and also what you think you can learn from listening to your own songs. Remember to subscribe, like, click the bell notification, share it with a friend, send me money, and I'll see you guys next week.